स्टैंड स्टूडेंट्स मैथमेटिक्स एक्सरसाइज 2.5 वी आर डूइंग डिवाइड यूजिंग कैंसिलेशन मेथड. दिस इज योर थर्ड मेन क्वेश्चन. ये क्वेश्चन 2,45,160 डिवाइडेड बाय 40. व्हाट इज दिस कैंसिलेशन मेथड? इट इज वेरी सिंपल. सी दिस इज कॉल्ड डिविडेंड. 2,45,160 इज कॉल्ड डिविडेंड. Whereas this 40 is called divisor. Here dividend you see last digit is 0. In divisor also last digit is 0. These two zeros get cancelled. So what remains? 2,45,16. 2,45,16 divided by here what remains? 4. So you have to divide like this. This is called cancellation method. Simple it is. And division you know as in first main, second main we have done. 4, 6 are 24. 4 minus 4 0, 2 minus 2 0. Next is bring down 5. 4 ones are 4. 5 minus 4 1. Next bring down 1. It is 11. 4 twos are 8. 11 minus 8 3. Last digit 6 bring down. It is 36 now. 4 nines are 36. 6 minus 6 0, 3 minus 3 0, these zeros you can write. Then the 6129, this is called quotient, that you should write here. And this is called 0 is the remainder. So remainder is 0. Next to C question, B question you take for homework. Next go for C question. What is the value of this? How much it is? 1, 10, 100, 1000, 10,000, lakh, 10 lakhs. It means 46,53,320 divided by 500. This last digit is 0. Here also last digit 0. These two zeros get cancelled and only remains 465,332. And here one zero is gone. 50 is there. You should write 50. And division as usual. See, if you take first digit 4, you cannot divide because the divisor is big, 50. Next two digit if you take it is 46. 46 is also less than 50. You cannot divide. So for that what you have to do? You have to consider three digits. 4, 6, 5. It means 465 divided by 50. 59 is a 450 and 465 below that only you should write 450 minus 5 minus 0 5, 6 minus 5 1, 4 minus 4 0. Next what you have to do? The 3 you have to bring down. Now it becomes 153. 53 is a 150. Subtract 3 minus 0 3, 5 minus 5 0, 1 minus 1 0, this 0 as it is. So 3 is remained there. Next what you have to do, next digit is 3, bring down. When you bring down 3, 3, 3 means 33 it is. 33 is less than 50, you cannot divide. So what you have to do, another digit you have to bring down, 2. Before bringing this digit 2 down, what you have to do, you have to put 0 here. Put 0 and bring down this 2. Don't forget to put 0. Because when 3 is brought here, it is 33, which you cannot divide by 50. So you have to bring another digit, next digit down. But before bringing this 2 down, you have to put 0. Afterwards, you have to bring 2 down. Now it is 332. 56 are 300. See, subtract 2 minus 0 2, 3 minus 0 3, 3 minus 3 0, these zeros as it is. So what is this 32? It is remainder, whereas 9306 is quotient, that you have to write here. Quotient 9306. Remainder 32. This is how you have to solve. D question. See here D question. 1 stands 100, 1000, 10,000 lakh, 10 lakh crore. 2 crore 24 lakh 79,700 divided by 800. See, last here, last two digits all zeros are there. Here also last two digits zero. These two zeros gets cancel. Here two zeros can cancel. Only 8 will be there here. 8 and divided by this dividend 2224 7 9 7. So 224 7 9 7. These two zeros cancelled. This is called cancellation method. And division, 8 2s are 16. Because first digit 2, if you take, it is less than 8, you cannot divide. So double digit 22 you must take. 8 2s are 16. Because 8 3s are 24, you cannot take more big number. So 8 2s are 16. 22 minus 16 is 6. Next bring down 4. 8 8s are 64. 64 minus 64 is 0. Then bring down 7. When you bring down 7, you cannot divide by 8 because it is 7 is small. 7 is smaller number. You cannot divide by 8. So you have to bring 9 down. Before bringing this 9 down, as you know, put 0 here and bring down 9. Then it is 79. Same 8 9s are 72. 9 minus 2 7, 7 minus 7 0. These zeros as it is you should write. So 9 minus 2 7. Next digit is last digit 7, you have to bring down. 77. Again 8 9s are 72. See here, 8 9s are 72. 7 minus 2 5, 7 minus 7 0. These zeros as it is. So what is the quotient? 28,099 quotient. Remainder is 5. This is how you have to subtract by cancellation method. Simple it is. Next problems in the next class. Next fifth standard students, exercise 2.5, fourth main we are doing. Divide mentally and fill in the empty boxes. This is your fourth main question. Divide mentally and fill in the empty boxes. This is A question. 607,148 divided by 10. This is a question and they have given quotient is equal to how much, remainder is equal to how much. You have to fill in this box. See, this is very simple. Mentally you have to do 607,148 divided by 10. How many zeros are there in divisor? Only one zero is there. So when there is one zero, you have to take the last digit of the dividend. This is the dividend and this is the divisor. One zero is there here. So one digit you have to take it, this as last digit 8, you have to take it as remainder and remaining these digits as quotient. So 60714, this is quotient and the 8 is remainder because only one zero is there. So last digit you have to take it as remainder. So 60714 is quotient, that you have to write here. 60714, this is quotient and 8 is remainder. Similarly, B question, you can see in B question 11,53,679 divided by 100. How many zeros are there here in divisor? Two zeros. So when there are two zeros, you have to remove these two digits, you have to take it as remainder and 11536, this is quotient. Last two digits 79 is remainder. So 11536 is the quotient. 11536, this is the quotient and 79 is the remainder, that you have to write it. Understood? Similarly, C question. 24,01,389 divided by 1000. See, in 1000, 1000, how many zeros are there? 3 zeros. So these 3 digits, 1, 2, 3, 389, you have to take it as remainder. And these digits, 2, 4, 0, 1 is quotient. So 2, 4, 0, 1 is quotient. That you have to write here. 2401, this is quotient, and 389 is the remainder. Very simple it is. Next, D question. 810,015 divided by 1000. How many zeros are there? 1, 2, 3. So start from here. 1, 2, 3. 015. 015 means 15. This 15 is the remainder and 810 is the quotient. So 810 is quotient. 015 means you can write 15. 15 is the remainder. It is very simple. So mentally you have to, orally you can see and write the quotient and remainder. Understood? Next exercise will continue in the next class.